السلام عليكم. We'll today talk about sensory neural deafness and conduction deafness and how to differentiate between them. The deafness, we have sensory neural and conduction deafness. The problem in the sensory neural in the nerve which transfers the sound to the brain. But the conduction, the problem in the wave which transfers the sound to the inner ear. So if the this external ear and this the tube inside of the lumen, these are problem here. These are problem here, maybe wax or cotton. This block the way to the inner ear or the tympanic membrane. So this conduction, this problem in the way which transfer the sound to the membrane. So how to differentiate between both type of this deafness? So we have two tests you have to know, because there's a lot of question about this. One called Rene test and Weber test. What's the this test and what's the importance of this test? If you have this ear and this mastoid process, in the Rene test you are bring the tunnel fork. This fork, you will put the vibrating fork in the mastoid process first. السلام عليكم. We will talk today about type of deafness and how to differentiate between them. We have two types of deafness. Is sensory neural deafness and conduction or conductive deafness. What's the difference between this? Sensory neural deafness in the problem in the nerve. Problem in the nerve which transfer the sound to the brain. So you can't hear because this problem in the nerve. But the conductive deafness, the problem in the way will transfer the sound. If this external ear and this the tube or lumen and this tympanic membrane, a problem here in the this way. So between maybe the wax or cotton, they can transfer the ear cannot, this sound cannot go through this way because this block. The general rule you have to know is the air conduction of the sound better than a bone conduction. So okay, the air conduction is better than a bone conduction. So the ear, we are here by air, it's okay, better than the bone conduction. So this the main rule here, the air conduction better than the bone conduction. So how do you differentiate between sensory neural deafness and conductive deafness? We have two important tests called Rene test and Weber test. What's the mechanism of this test? If our patient here and this ear and this mastoid process. So okay, this mastoid process. I'm sorry, but we can draw here mastoid process. So okay, what happened? How doing this test? As we informed, this air conduction better than bone conduction. In this case, in the Rene test, we ask patient, we bring tunnel fork. tunnel fork. We are both fork here in the mastoid process. And the patient will hear here when the you are feel the tunnel. Yes, I feel this fork. So is work this a bone conduction by the bone mastoid. Another one, after this we are put front of the ear, the fork in the front of the ear. Are you here? Yes. Normally, normal person, you have three scenario. In a normal person, he told you ear conduction, I hear here better than ear bone conduction. I hear this ear by ear better than the bone conduction. If the patient has sensorineural problem deafness, the both are decreased, air conduction decrease and the bone conduction decrease, but both still air conduction better than the bone conduction. This in sensorineural deafness, but in the bone conduction, in the conductive deafness, bone conduction better than air conduction. So okay, because if you have problem here, the air cannot go. If you have any closure here by wax or cotton, the air cannot go. So I block the air conduction. So the bone conduction. So the bone conduction better than the air conduction in the conductive deafness. Very, very important. Conductive deafness, you understand the conductive deafness. What conductive deafness? The air cannot go. So the bone, the patient depends mainly now on the bone. So the bone conduction better than the air conduction in the conductive deafness in the RENE test. So this is RENE. How to remember RENE is this test? RENE, remember PINI, this ear, RENE, PINI, and this RENE here. So normally air conduction better than bone conduction. When the bone conduction better in the conductive, air cannot go, so I depend mainly on the bone conduction. Another test is Weber test. What happened in the Weber test? This forehead, we are put here the tunnel fork in the middle of the forehead. We are put both feet. Normally, the patient equal here and here. Can clear here. We are put the tunnel fork in the middle of the forehead. This is the fork here. We are put here in the middle of the forehead. Was creation usual normal head patient here equal here usual here I am here I both equal where you are here better I both I hear in the same in the side of the ear in the normal person so are equal. If the patient has problem in sensorineural deafness, so okay, so in the mesen, if the nerve here a nerve here lesion nerve problem, so I can't hear here. So I can't hear. If this sensorineural deafness here, not here in the affected ear. If in the unilateral one, if the right side, مثلا, if right side ear sensorineural deafness, I can't hear in this right side. So okay, so if this problem unilateral, in affected ear, I can't hear this in the sensorineural deafness. But in the conductive deafness, conducting affected ear better than the normal ear. So in the sensorineural, I can't hear in the affected ear. So okay, if the affected ear, I can't hear. The affected ear, I can't hear because this nerve. But in conductive deafness, what happened in conductives? I hear better in the affected ear. Better in the affected ear, very, very important. In the conductive deafness, in conductive deafness, yeah, what conductive is this way is blocked. So, okay, so I hear better in the affected ear. In the affected ear is blocked the ear, I hear better. I hear better in the conductive deafness. So, okay, very, very important. Why? Because I depend mainly, normal ear depend on ear and bone. But in the conductive, but in blocked ear or affected ear depend only the ear. خلاص no, there's no air conduction. There's only the bone conduction. I depend only in the bone conduction. So it's better in conductive deafness. I hear better in the affected ear. It's very very important. So are the an exam very important to know. In the Rene test normally air conduction is equal bone conduction better. Air conduction better than the bone conduction. In the conductive deafness, the bone conduction better than the bone conduction better than the air conduction. So bone conduction better than air conduction in the conductive deafness. So okay. But here in the Weber test. If the normally I equal here in the both ear, in the sensorineural deafness I can't hear in the affected ear, but in conductive deafness I hear better in the affected ear. Very very important. In the conductive deafness hear better in the affected ear. This called Weber and Rene test. You have to know the difference between two tests. Very very important and the common question in the exam. Thank you.